My name is Kathy Fosno, and this is Kat's Creative Corner. Welcome to Tuesday's Card. Today we're going to be making this fall tree card using our Sheltering Tree stamp set. This tree can be used for all seasons. All you have to do is change the color of the leaves, and I love this stamp set. So in this one I used Peekaboo Peach for the background. On the card I'm going to show you, I'm going to use Crushed Curry. Okay, we're going to start with a piece of cardstock that's cut 4 1/4 by 11 and scored at 5 1/2. And then we're going to need a piece of Peekaboo Peach cut at 4 4 1/4 and another piece of Whisper White cut at 3 3/4 by 4 inches. And we're going to start by stamping the tree trunk, and we're going to use chocolate chip. I want to get it nice and inked, and we're going to use my piercing pad to stamp with, because a photopolymer stamp set doesn't have a cushion, and this kind of helps it. And I'm going to stamp very close to the top. And there's your tree trunk. I'm going to clean that off and then remove it. And I'll clean these better when I'm all done. Okay. And then I'm going to take my Garden Green and the little grassy knoll inside the stamp set, same stamp set. I'm using the same stamp set for the whole card this time. Okay, and I'm using my little grassy knoll. Whenever I say grassy knoll, I always think of the Kennedy assassination. The grassy knoll. I was 13 when that happened, so you can figure out how old I am now. And it just makes me think of it, and it's kind of a sad thought, isn't it? Okay, now we're going to take the leaves from the Sheltering Tree stamp set, and we're going to stamp it with Crushed Curry. Okay, get it good. And then we're going to take our Stampin' Write markers, and we're going to use the brush side. I've told you before that we have the pointy side and the brush side. And we're going to use the brush side because we just want to kind of tap our colors onto it. And you can't really see this real well, but it comes out better when you do put it on the paper. And we're going to use Cherry Cobbler. Actually, that was Pumpkin Pie. And this is the cherry cobbler, and you can see this a little better because it's a little darker. And you're just going for the different colored leaves like we have in the fall. Okay. You're going to put that right on the tree trunk. And there you go. And now I'm going to show you something. I'm going to wipe this off so that it's not too messy, and then I'm going to turn it over. I'm going to turn it over to where the flat side that normally sticks to the block is exposed. And I'm going to take my Crushed Curry, and I'm going to put it all over the block. You want to make sure you get to the center, because sometimes the center doesn't want to get on very well. And we're going to take that and we're going to press that over the tree. And look, isn't that awesome? I just love that. And this idea was from Teresa Howe. I really appreciate her sharing her idea on the websites, and I just love it. So I just decided I'm going to make a card using it. And we even did this in my card class last week, because I think it is so appropriate for this time. I'm going to move my pad for now. And I'm going to center this right on the Peekaboo Peach piece. And then I'm going to take a piece of my Peekaboo Peach ruched ribbon. And I'm going to take, And I'm going to, using my Snell adhesive, I'm going to put a little tape on each end of it, and then I'm going to, oops, did it the wrong end. Don't want it up there, I want it down by the trunk. Okay. So I'm going to put it there, and then wrap it around. And then using my paper snips, I'm going to cut it off. I hope that's seen. Did you see me do that? Hope you saw that. Okay, and then my leftover ribbon, I'm going to take and I'm going to tie a knot. I think I'll do it on this side. Nope, I'm going to do it on this side. Nope, I'm going to do it on this side. Oh, make up your mind, Catherine. Do it right there. Okay, and I'm going to trim that up. Okay, now I'm going to take my card base and I'm going to stick this on. And I always go over the ribbon so that the ribbon is sticky too, so it can stick to the cardstock. And I want to put it towards the top of the cardstock. Leaving a border on the bottom. And then all we have left is to do Thinking of You. And I think I'm going to do that in Peekaboo Peach just to coordinate a little bit. Now I got to make sure I got it the right direction. And again, I'm going to use my piercing pad. Sometimes if you huff on it, if it's set out for a minute or two, it makes it a little bit more moist to stamp. Okay, and I'm going to just write Thinking of You right at the bottom. And lift it, and that card is done. I hope you liked this card. If you did, I'd love it if you'd give me a thumbs up. If you really liked it, you can subscribe to my website or subscribe to this channel, and you can hop on over to my website, catscreativecorner.com, and find more cards and tips. Thanks for stopping by.